To make another case for explicit debugging, let me illustrate this with a game of Mastermind. You know Mastermind, don't you? Your opponent has 4 pins hidden behind a board, and your job is to guess the colors of these pins. So you come up with one trial, and you get points for every color that's in the right position, and for every color that's correct but not in the right position. This is what your opponent tells you. And so you make one attempt after the other, until after normally 7-8 attempts or so, you finally guessed the right combination. Mastermind is a prime example of applying the scientific method, coming up with one experiment after the other to validate or reject a hypothesis on what's behind these bars. And then, based on your observations, you come up with a new hypothesis and a new hypothesis. You gradually refine your hypothesis until you find the answer. Now, when you're playing Mastermind, you always record what you tried before and what the result was. This is the same as explicit debugging. You write down what you do and what the result was, and this is what makes you effective. Not writing down what you do is like playing Mastermind with a blindfold, trying to remember all the combinations and all the results. Sure, you can do that. You're a great thinker. You're a smart person. You could probably also play Mastermind blind. But why do that if you can simply look at what you already did, interrupt the session at any time, and resume later at wish? Think about your significant other and remove your blindfold.